Toastmaster and friends. I would like to take all of you tonight to think about your superhero or Avengers, okay? I'm talking about the real superheroes that actually inspire you or perhaps have changed you. Or, yes?
You're dead.
Okay, my dad. Or, okay, keep the answer in your heart. And, okay, I bet some of you might have your mom or your dad or your girlfriend, your boyfriend, as your real superhero. Or maybe someone that not so likable, like bosses. Any of you like, you know, have your bosses as real superheroes?
Yes.
No one? All right, that is my superhero. Some of my bosses, okay, not all my bosses. Some of my bosses. And I'm going to talk about that behind your back tonight. 15 years ago, I graduated from art school and my mom said, Esther, enough, go back and work. I don't have any more budget to spend on you. All right, and actually, they supposed to, you know, well, anyway. I'm gonna have to work. I juggled between a few different jobs and I finally settled down in one good company, and of course, as a graphic artist. I did quite well, I think, doing the design stuff. After a year, my boss came to me, Esther, I want you to take on marketing communications. And I'm like, what? No. No. I have no idea what is marketing. I have no idea what is communications. And even like, the other department, like all the PR ladies, like, Esther don't even know how to speak English. She doesn't even know how to write. Well, anyway, my GM was very, you know you can do it. Just, you know, I will provide you the support, I will provide you with trainings. I'm like, no. No thanks. And, well, he was very convincing, and, well, I took the challenge. Little that I know, my journey started from there. And it was like really motivated from one of his huge poster in his office, that Nike check icon, you know that? Just do it, yes sir, just do it, you know? Like this is the marketing communication, just do it. Just, you know, take ownership to learn. So then I moved from marketing communication role to public relations, and then at one stage, I actually managed weddings and events. I have no clue what is that. And, well, a corporate role for a beauty retail brand. Well, sometimes when, you know, along the way, it's not because I get paid. It's not because of a bigger paycheck in the end of the month. I have to work at the time, and most of the time I feel very stupid. Oh my God, it's so stupid. I have no clue what is this. And I have to bear with confusion, humiliation. I have to work overtime to understand what I have to do. But I always remember my other boss's advice. She said, Esther, working is just like entering a university. The good thing is, you don't have to pay. Wow. Well, 6 years ago, I took quite a huge challenge. I worked in a different country, and it was so tough. So it's like, I have to work on Saturday and Sunday, and my boss was super demanding. But at the same time, she was very inspiring, and she has this spirit, you know, like full of joy, even though she's very demanding. But she's a happy person, and she's very appreciative. Like, she always says thank you for everything that I did for her. And her super advice for me, Esther, work with people's strength. And this is what all my bosses have done. They focus on my strength instead of my weaknesses. They focus to work with me. And I hope this little story inspired you in any way to take on challenges. A new learning journey, I know it's difficult, I know it's scary. And this year I took two major challenges. This is the first one. This is the first speech without any cue cards for me in English. And the second one is I started off my career again in a totally different industry. And I hope my boss's super advices have motivated you and maybe liberated, you know, your potential out of you. And just like my boss said, just do it. Thank you.
First step in part three. So congratulations, you break your eyes already for
Thank
this
you.
Time. Thank you.
I took away three main statements. Work is like uni, you just don't have to pay. It's a strong statement, everybody remembers, everybody even laughs about it when you said it. So, great point for your first part of the speech. Later on, you said, focus on your strength. Again, very powerful, very memorable, and the very last one, just do it. So you basically use a phrase that is already famous all over the world. Again, very memorable, very strong, and I love that. Very cool. Your voice is very clear. I was lucky enough this evening actually to get to know you a little bit better, to actually figure out that you're together with Daniel and what you're actually doing for life. It's very interesting, by the way. And of course I know now that you speak a lot of English at your work, and that was very obvious to see here today. Your English is very clear, very concise, very strong. Allow me a few things that make your speeches in the future even more powerful. So one thing I noticed is that you stand here for quite a long time. You have a little bit of more space. There is somebody sitting here behind this pillar. If you move a tiny little bit and look in Angelica's eyes, she doesn't feel so neglected. If you give her a little bit of room, okay? She's very sad here in the corner. Like, no, she's not. But she enjoyed your speech. But just in general, you can move a little bit more and move on purpose. I did a lot at the beginning to move around a lot. I actually shaked a lot at the beginning. And I was able actually to learn that here in this club a lot, that moving with purpose is quite powerful and quite strong. So every time you sort of go to one of the next main points in your speech, to go step or two and then stand again. Another thing that I mentioned is, that I noticed, is that you use your hands already. That is great for your very first speech, very cool, but you also take them to the middle and to hold them together very often. What I got told in my first few months, 4 months with Toastmasters, it's actually the best if you just leave them hanging, and only if you really use them for a purpose, to use one or two hands, otherwise just leave them hanging. Holding them together seems to look more a little bit of a defensive role. Mm-hmm. Overall, I can say it was a very, very cool icebreaker, very inspiring, especially with the end that you closed again with a strong statement of just do it. And this way you encouraged everyone to overcome their fear of just taking a leap and go and focus on their strength and just do it. Thank you very much, Esther. I really enjoyed it, and I think everybody else, and I'm looking forward to your next speech. Thank you.